Hi, this is Shubham from Moonestio, and today in this podcast, we will have a deep dive in venture capitalism of a startup financing. Here we want to discuss the venture capitalistic concept, different characteristic advantages, the way venture capitalistic activated in various stages of funding, venture capital investment total process and method. If you want to read the full article, then the link of an article is in a description. So let's discuss what is this venture capitalist. Venture capital means a fund made available for a startup firm and a small business with an exceptional growth potential. Venture capital is a money provided by a professional along with management investment in a young, rapidly growing companies that have the potential to develop into a significant economic contribution. Venture capitalists generally finance a new startup through a purchase equity that add value to the company which has a potential growth. Let's understand the different characteristic of venture capital financing. First, long time horizon. The fund would invest with a long time horizon in mind. Minimum period of investment would be 3 years and it can go up to 10 years. Second, lack of liquidity. When VC invests, it takes into account the liquidity factor. It assumes that there would be a less liquidity on the equity it gets, and accordingly it would be an investing in a format. They adjust the liquidity premium against the price and required return. Third is high risk. VC would not hesitate to take a risk. It would be on a principle of a high risk and high return. So high risk would not eliminate the investment choice for a venture capital. Fourth, equity participation. Most of the time VC would be investing in a form of an equity of a company. This would help the VC to participate in a management and help the company to grow. Besides, lot of decisions can be survived by the VC if the participants of an equity company gets the right in written in the agreement. Let's discuss what are the advantages of bringing VC in the company. First advantage is a long-term equity finance, which is very crucial for any company or a startup. Second advantage is the VC is a business partner sharing both risk and reward. VC are rewarded with a business success and a capital gains. Third advantage is the VC is able to provide practical advice and assistance to the company based on the past experience and other companies which were in a similar situation. Fourth advantage is the VC also has a network of a contact in many areas that can add value to the company. Fifth advantage is VC may be capable of providing additional fund of round in the funding round for the future growth. Sixth advantage is a VC can experience in the process of preparing company for an IPO of its share into a stock exchange, domestic as well as overseas. The last advantage is VC can facilitate trade scale, which is a very key for the growth of a company. Let's discuss what are the stages of a funding of a VC. So there are basically a 6 stages. These stages are based on the amount of a money which the VC generate for a company or a startup. The first stage is seed money. It is a low level financing need to be through a new idea. So here basically a new idea is floated. Second one is a startup. This is early stage of firm that need funding for expenses associated with the marketing and product development. Here the product is actually packed, developed and established. Third stage is basically the first round. This is for early sale and manufacturing fund. Fourth stage is a second round. Over here working capital of early stage company is established and it is used for the selling a product but not for turning into profit. Here the objective is to get the product in the market to get the market size. The fifth stage is basically a third round of funding. It is also called as mezzanine financing. This is an expansion money for a newly profitable company. The sixth and last stage of a funding of a VC is basically a fourth round. It is also called as a bridge financing and it is intended to finance going for an IPO so that VC can ultimately get an exit position. After discussing the various stages of a funding of VC, let's discuss what is this VC investment process. Over here we will discuss how the VC approaches to the company from point of view of a getting into the financing until the point of an exit. So the entire VC investment process can be segregated into 6 parts. So the first is a deal origination. VC operates directly or through intermediately. Mainly many practicing chartered accountants in India or MBA guys from finance or any other consultancy firm would work in intermediary through them so the VC gets the deal. Before sourcing a deal, the VC would inform the intermediary or its employee about the nature of a company they are going for. So this basically include the SEC sector focus, stages of various business, promoter focus, turnover focus, etc. The second stage is a screening. Once a deal is sourced, the same would be sent for a screening by the VC. The screening is generally carried out by the committee of a consisting of a senior level people of a VC. Once the screening is happened, it would select the company for the further processing. The third stage is a due diligence. The screening decision would take into based on the information provided by the company. Once the decision is taken to proceed further, the VC now carry out a due diligence process. This is mainly the process by which the VC would try to verify the veracity of a documents taken. Over here, framework of a legal team would be a very crucial. This is generally handled by external bodies, mainly renowned consultants. The fees of due diligence generally paid by VC. However, in many cases, this can be shared between the VC as well as the company that is in investing, depending on the terms of agreement. The fourth stage is a deal structuring. Once the case passes through the due diligence, it would now go for a deal structuring. The deal is structured in such a way that the both parties win. In many cases, the convertible structure is brought in to ensure that the promoter retain the right to buy the share. Besides, in many structure to facilitate the exit, the VC may put a condition that promoter has also to sell a part of its stake along with the VC. Such a clause called as a tag alone clause. The fifth stage is a post investment activity. In this section, the VC nominates its nominee in the board of a company. The company has to adhere to certain guidelines like a strong MIS, strong budgeting system, strong corporate governance and other convenience of a VC. Keep periodically updated VC about the structure and how the company is going. If the milestone has not met, the company has to give an explanation to the VC. Besides, VC would also ensure that professional management is set up in a company. The sixth and last stage is exit plan. At this plan investing, the VC would ask the promoter or a company to spell out the details of exit plan. Mainly, exit happens in two ways. One way is a sale to the third party. This sale can be in form of an IPO or private placement or other ways. The second way to exit is that promoter would give a buyback commitment at a pre-agreed rate, generally between IRR of 18-25%. In the case the exit is not happening in the form of IPO or third party sale, the promoter would buy back. In many deals, promoter buyback is the first refusal method adopted. The promoter would get the first right to buy back. Now let's discuss what are the different methods of a venture capital financing. The first method is a equity financing. A venture capital undertaking generally require funds for a longer participation for the good fortune of a business in initial stages. Therefore, the venture capital financing is generally provided by way of equity share capital. The equity contribution of a venture capital firm does not exceed normally 49% of a total equity capital of a venture based on the effective control and ownership which remains to the entrepreneur. The second way of venture capital financing is a conditional loan. Conditional loan is repayable in the form of a royalty after the venture is able to generate sale. No interest is paid on such loans. In India, venture capital financers have charged a royalty range between 2-15%. Actual rate of return depends on the factors of generation period, cash flow of a business, risk involved and other factors. Some venture capital financing give a choice to enterprise of a paying high rate of interest, which would be as much as 20% instead of royalty on sales once it becomes a commercially sound. Third method of financing is income note. It is a hybrid security which combines the features of a both conventional loan and conditional loan. The entrepreneur has to pay a both interest and royalty on a sale, but statistically at lower rate. IDBI Venture Capital Fund provides a funding equal to 80-87.5% of a project cost of a commercial application of an indigenous technology or adoption of an imported technology to a domestic application. The fourth way of financing is a participating debenture. Such security carry a charge in a three phase. In the startup phase, no interest is charged. Next stage, a lower interest is charged, and after particular certain level of operations is achieved, the higher rate of interest is charged. This is very innovative way so that the debentures holder get a participation. Also, they get a generate income over the operations of a business.